Gonna be a pretty day today. I hope the wind doesn't pick up. Good morning. So the last couple of videos here I had with me and Jeff going up on the mountain there with his four-wheeler, and those guys I met, well, they're twin brothers, Jeff and his brother Greg, and I met them guys back in the early 80s, so we've been friends for 40 years, maybe a little more, and they are a lot of fun, both of them, but they are ruthless. The jokes they play on you and the things they do, holy smokes, they're something else. But there was one time that I had a broken leg, and so I'm on crutches, and we were up in the mountains playing around, and they said, well, I want to climb up to the top of this cliff here and get some pictures. I'm up there, and I bet the view is really neat. And of course I couldn't go, so I'm at the bottom of the cliff watching them climb up there. And it was a pretty good cliff. They got up probably, I bet, at least 100 feet. And they took a bunch of pictures and things, and they were hollering down from the top, boy, it's you should be up here. Boy, you could really see a long ways. This is great, and blah, blah, blah. And then they told me, well, this is Mom's camera, and I don't want it to break. I don't want to try climbing down with this camera, so I'm going to throw it to you. I told them, no, don't throw it to me. I'll miss, you know, it'll break. And their mom, she's like my second mom. I mean, she's great. I really loved that gal. But I sure didn't want to break her camera. And I told them, no, don't throw that. And they threw it. And so I'm watching this thing flying out of the sky. And they purposely threw it about 30 feet off to the side where I could never catch it. And like I say, I'm on crutches with a broken leg. So I threw my crutches down and I ran on that broken leg, and I caught the camera. I did. I caught it. And I'm howling in pain. They're howling in laughter because the camera wasn't the camera. It was just the camera case. And I mean, the jokes they play, holy smokes. I got even. I broke their fingers and things over the years, and cut Greg on the back of the hand with a real sharp knife. That was a bad one. I didn't mean to do that. That was an accident. But it's no wonder we're all so crippled up, the things we've done to each other. But anyway, today, I'm back to work. I got changed the teeth on that plow again already. They're worn down to nubbins. I got to figure out a spot to plug my welder in because that one tine is broken. I got to try to fix that. I don't know where to plug it in at, though. That my plug-in for the welder was in that shed we tore down. And these roping steers over here, they roped yesterday. They're out of hay. I got to throw them a little bit of feed. And anyway, more normal stuff. They dug the trench for the foundation on this one restroom a couple of days ago. It doesn't really, to me, look all that much bigger than what we had before. This one is, but the other end doesn't look all that much bigger, but I guess it is. Wait and see what it looks like when it's done, I guess. Really what we are looking for is more toilets and things, and as long as it's bigger on the inside, it doesn't really matter. Same with this one. Hopefully they can get these rebuilt fairly fast, but I don't know. There's always a holdup, it seems. One thing I really like about this plow is how easy these tines come off. There's just a little spring clip, and you pull the pin, and it drops on out the bottom. But right now, the ground we have here has a lot of clay in it. Bentonite clay, they call it. When it dries, it's like cement. And it dries like a rock. And some of this, I can't even find the clips right now. You have to chip all that off and clean this up. And having that shed torn down kind of messed me up in a lot of ways. It's harder to find things. As cluttered up as that shed was, at least I knew where things were. I'm not even sure where my grease gun is or anything. Well, makes it a little more of a challenge, I guess, to find stuff. That hopefully they'll get a new one built before too long and I can reorganize things. It's going to be an interesting year. Stuff out of that shed, like I said, all kind of piled up on pallets and things, and sure hard to find anything. But it is what it is. Hopefully I'll have a place to put it before too long. Last time when I was replacing these teeth, had a couple of people ask me about the socket wrench I was using. And kind of a neat one. It's got both a half-inch drive and a 3/8 drive. Got a nail puller, a hammer. Those parts are kind of late duty. And then on this end, it's got the spud tool so you can line up bolt holes and things. I'm not really sure why there's a hole drilled in it there. Probably got a use that I don't know about. But it's kind of nice if I have the same size socket for both sides. I don't have to flip this and stuff to reverse the direction. I just flip it over, which ain't no big deal to do that. But it's kind of a nice little tool. I got it from Tractor Supply up in Missoula, Montana a few years back. And I use this thing a lot. Got busy with things today. Almost forgot about the beaver tails. This one here, that deer hide, it is starting to turn brown. I don't know, it's kind of strange. It's just like wet rawhide, which is exactly what it is, but it's not plumping up again like a fresh hide would have. I don't know if maybe that isn't going to really take the tanning the way I want it to or not. I never tried a deer hide before. So that'd be kind of interesting to see how that turns out. Okay, then wind is blowing just enough. This door won't stay open. Okay. It's still not going to stay open. I need a bigger stick or something. Anyway, beaver tails. They're looking really good. Grab one out of there. They're starting to look like tan leather. Yeah, let me grab the tripod and we'll cut off a little sliver of this, see what it looks like. White, but they're not completely brown either, so they're getting there, and that is by far the thickest part. Let's try if I get a little bit thinner spot here. Let's see. Need to bring out some scissors. those are looking really good. They're probably actually tanned because the rest of it's thin. But we'll leave them a little bit longer. And like before, I'll dump out a couple inches of it. Put that right into the deer hide one. Since I'm not sure that one's going to work anyway. And then fill it up again. Fill it up with the straight stuff. Let's see, let me mix that. Now, as many times as I've done that, that's turning awful dark. That's got to be almost straight concentrate, the same as what's in that bucket. But doing a couple inches at a time kind of dilutes it as well as strengthens it. And I got enough to do it one more time, so I'll leave it at least another week. And maybe more, but they're looking good. They should be pretty well tanned here. The deer hide, I'm not so sure. Well, I got the teeth changed on that. I did not get the one welded yet. Well, my uncle down the road, he called and I went over and helped him for a little bit. He's kind of having some problems. But now I'm changing oil in the tractor. Nothing very exciting or worth watching, folks. So, thank you for watching anyhow, and see you tomorrow. Hopefully you find something better than this. See ya.